Nieto aquí en Auto 060 y vamos a terminar el show de esta semana con una entrevista muy especial, diferente si acaso porque no es precisamente de autos, es de la compañía de la que hablamos en el segmento anterior, Bombardier Recreational Products, una compañía canadiense que hace cosas muy divertidas, la verdad, porque es la Can-Am Spyder, el Ski-Doo, el Sea-Doo, o sea, vehículos para recreacionales totalmente. Y bueno, en la presentación del nuevo modelo, el modelo Spark del Sea-Doo, tuvimos la oportunidad de hablar nada menos que con el presidente y director ejecutivo de la compañía, señor José Boscioli, quien nos va a dar más detalles del producto como tal, de la compañía y de algo muy interesante que pasa también con los fabricantes de autos, y es la expansión que están teniendo en México para producir sus vehículos y exportarlos al resto del mundo. Así que aquí vamos a la entrevista con José Boscioli, el presidente y director ejecutivo de Bombardier Recreational Products.
Well, first of all, thank you very much for having us here. It's been a very educative experience for me. We talk mostly about cars here, but anything that has an engine and goes fast and it's fun belongs in the show, and your new product definitely does.
Good. Happy about that.
Yeah. So can you tell, for people who are not very familiar with this BRP and the whole company, can you just briefly tell us about the company?
I mean, we are a Canadian-based company. We exist for more than 50 years, and we always been involved in recreational product. The company was founded by Joseph Armand Bombardier, who invented the snowmobile, and from the snowmobile we have had the watercraft. We're involved in ATVs, side-by-side, the Roadster, the Roadster Spyder, and we also manufacturing Evinrude outboard engine. Then we are a company who sell right now in 105 countries worldwide, and we have factory in Europe and in North America, in Mexico, United States, and Canada. We employ about 6,800 people. Then diversified product portfolio, diversified dealer network, and diversified manufacturing footprint.
Yeah, the Sea-Doo, it's your main product? Is that the massive? The
Sea-Doo is an important product line for us. It was our second product line that we came into. Sea-Doo is still a very important product line, part of our seasonal product category.
Yeah. But I understand that the industry, the personal craft, has been in a crisis for quite some time, right?
I mean, we entered the watercraft industry in 1989, and we had an incredible growth from 92 to 97, 98. In 97, 98, the industry started to decline. There was some bad press about some accident, about the two-stroke engine. And it was not as cool as it used to be. And since the watercraft industry has flat out, and it's still a good industry, but we're looking for something to re-spark that industry, to re-spark, to start another life cycle, you know.
Yeah.
And we believe that with the Spark we will succeed.
Okay, you just mentioned the Spark, so the new product and something completely new. And if you were making a comparison to a car industry, the auto industry, it would be like, for example, when Porsche came, had the 911, and then they had the Cayman?
Yeah, you could see it that way, even if it's a bit the reverse. What we were trying to do is, maybe another example, because it's going down, not up, the BMW. You know, BMW had the 3 Series, the 5 Series, the 7 Series, and they came out with the 1 Series, you know, a car that has the pure DNA of BMW, but is more affordable, fun, and a bit more younger to attract
more
people.
Yeah, I was talking about the Cayman, not the Cayenne, not the SUV, the Cayman.
you're right, sorry about that.
No, it's okay, but it's more or less like, so making a very cool product that has all the characteristics of the company, of the brand, of the other products that you make and sell. But still very fun. We already tried it for a full day, and it's pretty amazing. And someone like me that don't have too much experience and all that, Jax, your designer, saw me going out and said, oh, you didn't really push it that hard. And I said, well, I didn't want to be the first journalist that make that stupid mistake on the first lap. So I went easy, But then the learning curve is easy too. Within
easy.
An hour, I was like pushing the whole throttle, the whole thing, and it's pretty amazing. So congratulations on that, because it's a fun product. It really is. And that was one of the mandates when you started this project, right? Which took a long time to do.
The code name, the internal code name of the product was, because for every project we have an internal code name, was CAFE, for clean, affordable, fun, easy to use. And the mandate was to deliver on those 4 points, and I believe that our people have done a very good job.
So the Spark is a smaller, more affordable water personal craft. I understand the pricing is one of the more amazing things. The technology, the design, and everything are cool, but the pricing is pretty shocking. I understand it's like almost $1,000 less than anything else in the market.
The goal was to put two watercraft on a trailer for the price of one. Then today we're launching this year a family of watercraft, and the entry level 1+1 60 horsepower model is $49.99, and you have many model up to $71.99. Then you have a family of vehicle in that price range, which make it again affordable for a younger family.
Yeah. Another thing about some people have concerns about towing and where to start the thing. It's really light. When they first showed us to us the other night, they had the cannon out of the lake, and then three boys and one girl pick it up like nothing. Put it on the stand. It was pretty amazing. So it's light, which also helps with the performance, but it also helps with towing. Like you don't need a big car to tow it. Right?
Absolutely right. It's about 450 pounds. Then it's about half the weight of today a normal watercraft, and it's very easy to, like you said, to move around on the dock or on the beach, and a small car will easily pull it on the trailer.
Yeah. The other big news about your company besides the product is you have a new plant in Mexico, right?
Yeah, we have. We transfer some production from Canada to Mexico in Juarez in 2005. And the Juarez factory right now is...
That's in Canada?
That Juarez in Mexico.
Oh.
It is full. And we decided to build a new factory in Querétaro.
Oh, okay.
And in Querétaro right now, we started the factory is done. We started the assembly of engine last November. And the CAFE, the Spark production, CAFE is a cool name again. The Spark production started on August 5th. And all the watercraft will be assembled in Querétaro in the next 2 years.
For the whole world.
Yeah.
That's great news about Mexico. I think like companies like you trusting Mexico are like really helping not only your industry, but like a whole country in a way.
Absolutely. For us, we have factory in Canada, we have factory in the United States, and now two factory in Mexico, and we're very happy with our footprint in North America.
Well, thank you again for your time, for information, and especially for the fun that I had in the past few days. And where can the audience find more about Sea-Doo?
I mean, obviously you go on our website, BRP or Sea-Doo website, and you have all the information.
Sea-Doo.com?
Sea-Doo.com.
And BRP.com too.
Yep.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much again, and I hope to see you soon.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Pues ese fue José Bojolí, el presidente y director ejecutivo de Bombardier Recreational Products, la compañía canadiense que, como escucharon ahí, fabrica, entre otras cosas, el Sea-Doo. Habían empezado con el Ski-Doo, que es la moto para la nieve. Interesante ver cómo una industria que tiene cierto paralelo con la industria de los autos ha tenido sus altibajos y ha estado realmente en caída desde hace ya varios años. En algún momento llegaron a vender 200.000 unidades por año y ahora están alrededor de 40.000. Así que Sea-Doo espera que con el nuevo Spark 2014 puedan, como lo dice el nombre en inglés, Spark, reiniciar, volver a darle un impulso a esta industria y hacerla otra vez productiva y eficiente. Así que bueno, no se vayan esto, no, ya se tienen que ir porque esta es la última edición, el último segmento de Auto 060. Los espero próximamente aquí nuevamente en Cristina Radio Network.
Este programa fue una producción de National Latino Broadcasting.